Joining us on the line is Representative Maria Elvira Salazar. She, of course, is a congresswoman from Miami's Little Havana neighborhood, daughter of Cuban exiles, and she defeated former Clinton Foundation President Donna Shalala in 2020. It was considered the biggest upset of the election cycle. Representative Salazar, great to talk to you.
My pleasure to be with you, Ben.
So why don't we talk about the latest crisis on the border? The Biden administration is now removing the CDC mandate, the Title 42 mandate that allowed thousands of people pretty much every day to be turned away from the border without admitting them for asylum. Now that has been removed. DHS is suggesting 18,000 people a day could be descending on the southern border, which is hundreds of thousands of people every single month. You've proposed something called the Dignity Act, which is an attempt to actually reorganize the immigration system. Why don't you talk about that a little bit?
Yes. Well, about this Title 42, it's terrible, not only for the Hispanics, the Browns, the Latinos, the largest minority in the country, 20% of the population, is horrible for us and for the rest of the Americans. Why? Because that's going to send a very big, clear signal to the coyotes. The border is open. Business is good. The caravans can start coming in. And we're going to have hundreds of thousands of new undocumented, those child sex traffickers, those who want to traffic with drugs. I mean, the whole world wants to come in. So I just want to make sure, Ben, that you understand and your audience is that the Hispanics do not want open borders. The problem is that no one is asking us. The Democratic Party has been speaking for us for the last 35 years, and that is why I have presented the Dignity Law, which is the first time that the GOP, a brown girl from the hood with an accent, who was the biggest upset in the country, and was able to defeat one of the bastions of the Democratic Party, is saying to my Republican Party, it's time to welcome the Hispanics and to seal the border with everything we have, and then take care of those who are in here. That's what the Dignity does. And this Title 42 is horrible because, you know what, and with this I'll end, is that it takes the importance out of the urgency, or it gives the what's urgent and takes away from the important. What's important? To seal the border and to take care of those who are inside with dignity, not path to citizenship. Dignity, which is different.
So Representative Salazar, let's talk about the difference between what you're calling dignity and a path to citizenship. So on a practical level, what does that look like for the people who are here? I agree with you, obviously. I think everyone basically agrees that this is a two-stage process. Stage one is you got to shut the border. The idea that you're going to deal with everybody who is here while you have kept the border open is what leads to incentivization of illegal immigration. But let's talk about, you know, best of all possible worlds, we've closed the border. We now have an organized immigration system. People aren't crossing the border tens of thousands at a time and being released into the interior of the country. So now what is the path for the people who are here if it's not a pathway to citizenship?
If you have been here for more than 5 years and you have American children and you have not committed a crime, because if you committed a crime, you're out. If you have paid taxes, if you have a job, if you have roots in this country more than 5 years, we're going to give you the Dignity Visa or whatever you want to call it. That means that every 2 years you come out of the shadows, you start paying taxes, they pay you minimum wage or whatever is the market price. You will not be deported. You can go home for Christmas. You cannot claim government assistance, but you can continue living your life in dignity. And Ben, let me tell you something. I know that is what my people want. The problem is that Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats have convinced the whole world, including some of my GOP friends and members of Congress, that is this path to citizenship or nothing. No, there's something in the middle called dignity. Let me just give you one stat that will substantiate what I'm saying. In 1986, Ronald Reagan gave path to citizenship to 3 million people. 86, last time that an immigration reform law passed by Congress. You know how many people took up that offer? 70% did not. 70% of those people who could take path to citizenship decided to continue being Mexicans or Hondurans or Guatemalans or Puerto Rico or Nicaraguans. Why? Because what we want, the Hispanics, the people who are undocumented, they want to live in dignity and they want to continue being who they are. So you want to have an honorable life, raise your kids, not be deported, because if you're deported, then you lose everything that you have accumulated in the promised land. And that's it. And they don't need government assistance. But the problem is that this is a political fallacy that the Democratic Party has played very smartly. And we, the GOP, need to wake up to that. That's why I presented the Dignity. So after those 10 years in the dignity plan, it doesn't matter if you've been here for 10, 12, or 15 years illegal. After 10 years, if you choose to really become an American citizen, because we do not want to create a second-class citizen class, then you go into the redemption path, very biblical, because I am a woman of faith. And then after the 10 years, on the 11th year, what you do is that you go into the redemption path, and there you learn English, you pay more taxes, you take an exam, and then you go to the back of the line. My people won't care, because during all those 10, 12, 13, 15 years, they have lived a dignified life, and they have not been deported, and they've been able to go home for Christmas or bury their dead. So this is my quest. This is my lane within the GOP. It's time for us, the Republican Party, understand, welcome the Hispanics. And you know why, Ben? Because the neo-Marxists have penetrated the Democratic Party, unfortunately. I'm Cuban-American, first generation. I know what the Marxists do to you. And unfortunately, a lot of people in the Democratic Party have drank the Kool-Aid that socialism, democratic socialism, whatever socialism, however you want to shroud it or cover it in, is really perverse. And the only way I think that the Republican Party is not perfect, the Republicans, but we're not socialists, can neutralize that force is by bringing a new pool of voters that we welcome them. And those voters are the largest minority in this country, the Browns.
That's Representative Maria Salazar. I really appreciate the time.